Okay, we'll get started now. Sorry for the delay. Yeah? Sorry for the delay, but this actually brings up a pretty interesting concept when it comes to business, because you're forced to make choices every single day. I assume everybody in here has a business, am I correct? Can I get an idea of what they are? What is personal training?
Personal training.
Do you have your own center?
Yes.
And
personal training.
Your own center? Out of somebody else's?
Yes.
Looking to have your own center?
Yes.
Okay.
Personal training?
Yes.
My own center, looking to have them.
Okay.
Completely different. Check cashing, fee-based financial services.
Okay.
Personal training, looking to get my own facility.
Your own facility, you're working out of somebody else's right now? Okay.
Personal training.
Okay. Out of somebody else's
facility? Garage gym, so my own.
So it's yours, okay.
Strength coach and personal training, working out of the facility.
Out of somebody else's facility? Okay, looking to get into?
I'm just starting right there now.
Starting there, so mainly building client base.
It's a MMA gym, so it's...
Okay, okay, so your biggest takeaway would be how to build a bigger client base.
Yeah.
Okay, okay, okay.
Personal training with the garage gym.
Okay, well, I know what Rob does. Rob's got his own training center here in Columbus, boxing, and you're just a gym.
Personal gym,
is it personal training or full commercial gym? Yeah.
She belongs to me.
So you train. You're whose wife?
Mark's.
Oh, okay, 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 okay. 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 Then those guys back there are just innocent bystanders. But every day we're forced to have to make choices, you know, based upon the customers. So for example, this morning we'll use the example of two people who got lost. You ask yourself, you know, as far as customer service, do you start or do you wait? All right, because you can say, well, if you start, that's great service to them. All right, but if you wait, how good is that service to the eight people that are sitting here waiting? So you're kind of in that dilemma where you got to weigh the pros and the cons of what it is. Then you got to ask yourself, oh, are they late because inadequate directions, inadequate contact information, whose fault is it? Okay, because the assumption that could easily be made would be, man, I can't believe these guys are late. You know, what they do is, you know, stay up late partying or whatever it is. Or could it be they didn't have my cell phone number? You know, so you got to always weigh it, not make assumptions, make sure you have all the information before you do that. Fact of the matter is, yeah, they were lost. Fact of the matter is, yeah, they didn't have my contact information. When did I realize that? Well, 5 minutes ago, 10 minutes ago. So then I called them. Business lesson number two. You know, always have contact information of everybody you're going to do business with to call them. You know, because what's the other option? To sit here and to say, wait, we'll see if they find it or not? Or in my profession, a lot of the times it's, man, I'm not going to call them because then they're going to have my cell phone number. They'll call me all the time. Am I right? Am I wrong? Okay. So the choices have to be made, but the choices have to be made based upon all the information that you know without false pretenses. Okay. This is business 101 every single day. And it's not even part of my presentation. It's just what's out there. You know, so it's not about the customers are first and the customers are always right, because we know that's not always true. Okay. It's about doing the right thing based upon the given circumstances in the given situation. So, to begin with, I need to apologize to these guys for not having my cell phone information on there. Then I need to apologize to you guys for starting late. All right, business lesson number three, take responsibility. Okay, these are all important lessons that just kind of came out of nowhere, but they are very important. So, with that being said, welcome to the Passions into Profit Seminar. This is a concept that Mike Sederik and I came up with a few months ago, kind of put it out there to see how it would go. We didn't really fly the first time, so we had to move the date. We think you're going to get a tremendous value from the seminar. The reason why we're filming the seminar is to be able to put it into the market so other people can see what the value of the seminar can be. We think that there is a void and there is a niche for consulting in the fitness industry. Because the one thing that Mike and I realized is giving, all things being equal, if you had to choose between an accountant who was a lifter and one who was not, who would you pick? Who would you pick? Every single time. If you do what we do, you're going to go with the lifter. But we've been burned enough times that I did say all things being equal. Okay, because a lot of times that may not be the best guy. You know, when it comes to business, you got to go to the best guy. So, you know, the vision, the goal of we had is to be able to create a network of professionals who have that one like goal, you know, of fitness and strength, to be able to be a go-to. That way it's actually a more pleasant relationship. You know, a lot of the guys that are speaking, I've used as contractors. You know, it's fun. You know, it's fun to be able to send somebody an email like, oh, dude, did you see what so-and-so did? It has nothing to do with, you know, business whatsoever. You know, because there's a relationship, there's a better bond that's involved with that. So that's kind of the bigger vision behind all this. The other vision behind it is, and as I wrote in the book, Under the Bar, a lot of the values I feel you need for business come from the weight room. And that's what my presentation is pretty much going to be about. It's going to be about really simple business basics that everybody forgets about. And they totally miss because they get, it's like training, okay? We all train, right? All right, with training, if you have a weak point in your squat, bench, deadlift, I'm former powerlifter, dude, so this is where it's coming from. All right, squat, bench, or deadlift, everybody wants to know what's that exercise they need to do to make it better. All right, look on the Q&A, look on any forums, look anywhere. That's the most popular thing. Hey, what do I need to do to bring my triceps up to get my bench bigger? What do I need to do, what exercise do I need to do to be stronger out of the hole? All right, meanwhile, they forget all sticking points and training, business, and life are either mental, technical, or physical. Okay, everybody always wants to look at the physical first. What exercise? But what they don't realize is the mental and the technical are 90% of the battle. You know, I can take somebody's squat, reinforce their technique, and get them to squat a PR in one day. It could be a 50-pound PR. It's happened many times ringing people out here. How long would you have to train to put 50 pounds on your squat just from a physical standpoint? It took me 7 years to put 5 pounds on my bench. You know, then I changed my technique. Guess what? It went up like 70 pounds. Oh, so it was technical, so I wasted 5 years. So the point being,